available on my website. So thanks for know. Want to check it out? Reiki is a form of energy healing. It is a Japanese traditional medicine, and it is typically done by placing placing their hands on the patient. One of my favorite quotes from Einstein is, "Energy can never be created nor destroyed. Energy can be transferred, and energy can be absorbed from one thing to another, but it's always there." Reiki is universal, and ki is life force energy. Reiki is universal, omnipresent, everywhere at the same time. It's our spiritual consciousness, the omniscient wisdom from God or the higher self. Ki is a non-physical vitality that gives life to all living things. Ki energy can be activated through healing. This is on the 7 chakra points, and it heals physical ailments, mental, spiritual. It focuses on healing of energy on all levels. And Reiki is practiced through touch. The practitioner simply places their hands on the patient's chakra points. But it's a little more intuitive than just the crown, third eye, throat chakra. As a Reiki practitioner myself, intuition is super important to my practice, so I focus on my patient's energy point. It can also be done through distant, which is absolutely amazing. It means you don't have to be in the same room as the person you're giving Reiki to, or the same room as your practitioner to reap the benefits of Reiki. Energy can transcend time and space. One thing that's super important, and I just really want to make clear in this video, as I am a Reiki practitioner myself, is Reiki stimulates a person's natural healing abilities. So I may go to a practitioner for Reiki healing, or you may come to me for Reiki healing, but you, the person receiving the Reiki, is the one doing the healing on yourself. When you come to me for a Reiki session, I'm simply just a vessel transmuting the energy. I'm not doing the healing. And I want to make that so clear, because you are healing yourself. You are powerful. I'm just guiding that. And I feel like there's a lot of really toxic stuff going on in the New Age group, and I don't want to be a part of it. I want to spread Reiki around. I want to heal others, the world, how it changed my life, and what I've learned, and help others. But I don't want to come off as if I'm this guru, I'm the healer. No, come to me, pay me this money, you know, for life, and I will heal you of all your problems. No, that is not what Reiki is. I want to give you the tools to heal yourself. So there's something that really, really important. So a full Reiki treatment rebalances the mind, body, and spirit. Typically a full Reiki session is an hour long. I also do 30-minute sessions, and today's video is just a very brief session just to give you a glimpse of where Reiki is. I definitely think a full hour is where you'll reap all the benefits. So Reiki generally focuses on the 7 chakra points. So we have the crown chakra, third eye, throat chakra, heart chakra, solar plexus, sacral, and root chakra. And Reiki is very intuitive. So when I do a Reiki session, I let my intuition guide me and feel a person's energy and what areas are needing healing, where there's an imbalance, where down or work your way up. It's intuitive. That's how I do my Reiki. Before I had become a Reiki practitioner, I had been getting Reiki sessions done myself for about every month for 8 months. And it absolutely changed my life for the better. And just to give you a glimpse of my first session, I was a little skeptical of it. I didn't really know what to think. I was interested. I had been meditating for a while. I had done a few meditations where I astral projected and had amazing experiences. And I've always had extremely lucid dreams, and I remember them. So it wasn't too foreign to me, and it was always something that I was interested in. But in all honesty, I wasn't really sure it was going to happen. There's a lot of fake stuff, unfortunately, and just laying there, how could I be healed by someone's touch? But that's the thing, I'm not healed by touch alone. You're the one doing the healing, and I don't think it's like how Western society likes to think things as, hey, just give me this and I'll be healed. No, you're not gonna log out of one Reiki session being absolutely healed from all traumas, but you will leave feeling better. You will leave feeling more relaxed. You'll feel balanced. Your chakras will be balanced. So, anyways, kind of got off on a tangent there. I did have my skepticism, I guess, with my first session. When it comes to my first Reiki experience, I preface this by saying the night before, I had an edible, and I just want to be clear, I don't smoke weed. I have nothing against people that smoke weed, at all, but I just personally don't. I have anxiety, and it just amplifies that, and with me taking that edible the night before, a friend had given it to me, and I don't blame the friend for this. They thought it was just CBD. And I have a lot of muscle pain, so I take CBD regularly. And if you guys don't know, CBD doesn't get you high, doesn't have THC in it, but it does have a muscle relaxer kind of effect to it. So my friend gave me a bubble, and we both thought it was just CBD, and I thought I would just go to sleep and have a nice relaxing night, and it would help my muscle pain. Well, it was a THC edible. So that being said, I got really high that night, and I'd like to say it was just a fun, ooh, high night. No, I got really paranoid. I'd have my friend hold me because I was having a full-on panic attack, and I think part of it was I didn't think I was going to get high. I didn't expect to get high. I'm surprised. And also, like I said, I haven't smoked weed since I was a teenager, so really sensitive to it, and I just freaked the fuck out. So that was great. That was the night before I had my first Reiki session. So that being said, when I went into my first Reiki session, I feel like I still kind of had some after effects of that. I don't know, it might be that I was still high, but I was definitely more open to whatever spiritual realm at that point. So I kind of just lay down not knowing what to expect, and the practitioner, who is a really good friend of mine, kind of told me, you know, she'd been doing Reiki for years, and she's had some experiences where it was like she was performing an exorcism on her clients. They would do crazy stuff. Talk about someone else's experience, but basically how she told me, it was like a client was levitating off the table, like that kind of crazy exorcism type, and I didn't know what to expect. I was like, holy shit, is this going to happen to me? Am I going to exorcism now? I didn't, but laugh, some people cry, some people you become overcome with emotion. She said, whatever you do, just let it go. If you're gonna laugh, just laugh. If you're gonna cry, cry. I mean, do not hold it in, because that Reiki is, you know, that transfer of energy, it's that healing, it's letting it out, whatever you need to let out. So that's what she told me, and that was important, so I had that in my head. And so laid down, it was like a massage table, it was very comfy, dim lights, very relaxing, it was at a spa. And she did some tuning fork around my head just to help some other spiritual realm during this session, and it was absolutely amazing. I had never had a subsequent Reiki session as spiritual as the first one. The first one was mine, and it freaked me out a bit, I will be honest. I kind of had a panic attack too. So I don't know if it was the fact that I had THC in my system still, and that it was still a little bit tripping out, or maybe it just being my first one, I really let go into it. I didn't have any, convictions, but I was convinced after that first session. And it was really, it just opened up a lot of doors for me. It healed me a lot. And it's not always going to be like that. You're not always going to have some crazy spiritual experience with Reiki. I've had some where I didn't see any visions, but I just leave feeling absolutely relaxed. Nearly every time for me, I see colors. Yellow, like I said, is the main color I see. But I have seen swirling colors of all the different seven chakras. And I've also had other visions of past lives. It's really insane. And I'm not just saying this is actually real. I was skeptical at first, and if I hadn't had it myself and watching this video, I'd say, no, you're full of shit, that's not true. No, it's real. It's amazing. So that was my first session anyway. There was a little bit of anxiety with certain parts of the Reiki during my first time. I think it was just because it was so intense and I wasn't expecting that. But I just went with it. I knew that I was healing myself, and I think it was the icky things I had inside me coming out. The crying, and it wasn't so much feeling sadness, but it was just feeling regret in certain areas. Those kind of feelings that the healing session really gave me closure for. Like, you know, I let myself be sad, Reiki energy, you know, it would transpose to those areas that let me heal, let me feel, and come out stronger, come out more balanced, and able to be the person I am. So that was my first session. Mind-blowing. And that was a very pivotal moment in my life, becoming a mom. And I just felt as if I was reliving that moment again. It was beautiful. I started crying, and it wasn't, crying. It was just tears and tears of joy. And I also saw a lot of yellow. And I've looked into aura colors, and I really believe that my aura is yellow. I've tested it, which I can put on the channel if you guys want, just how to see your aura, how to see others' auras. And mine is yellow, it's a golden yellow, and that was a color I saw. And it was interesting because my soul most active when she did that Reiki session. So after seeing my child in my tummy, it's as if I was watching a movie. I saw them grow into young men. And mind you, my kids at the time were 4 and 6. They're 5 and 7 now, so this is about a year ago. But I saw both of them, and it was separate times because of different ages, but graduating from high school, and they were men, which is just so crazy to think about. It's as if I went to the future in this section, and I saw them walking across the stage, getting their high school diplomas, graduating, and I just remember feeling so proud. It's so amazed. And there was a lot of crying in this, a lot of smiling, a lot of joy. It's just a really, really spiritual experience, looking back on it. I also, another big thing in my life is that same year, you know, it's about, I think, 6 months before this Reiki session, I had lost my grandfather, who was like a dad to me. And that was, to this day, the hardest loss I've ever gone through. But he came to me in this Reiki session, and I saw his face clearly, and it wasn't like he was talking like how we're talking, you know, I'm talking now, but it was more a feeling. It was a sense of, I'm proud of you, is what I got. So I was very, very open to mind-blowing. And right after that, I just wanted more. I wanted more sessions. I wanted to know more. I wanted to learn more. I wanted to learn how to do this myself. And a big part about becoming a Reiki practitioner is, you know, healing yourself first. Because if you're not balanced as a practitioner, how can you heal others? How can you, you know, it's important to fill your cup first and then spread that to others. So that was what I focused on for the first 9 months as a Reiki practitioner, is just getting my chakras aligned, getting balanced. And I still have to remind myself, like, hey, you know, I suffer from frequent headaches. What's out of balance here? I have insomnia, you know. There's something, it's my anxiety triggering it, and why do I have anxiety? Let's lay down, and I will do Reiki on myself, and I will feel so much better. So it's really amazing, this life force energy that comes from it, and amazing benefits, and I'm just so excited to share that with others. So if you stuck around the video this long, I would love to do a free Reiki session with you guys. So just get into a comfortable position, lay down, sit in a meditative pose,